and it does have an official English translation. It's not terrible, actually, the English translation. They really improved it from the first chapter. But if web novels and novels aren't really your thing, I have actually done audiobook versions of the first two chapters. I'm working on chapter 3 at the moment. Once chapter 3 concludes on Digimon.net, I'll release it on podcast platforms and on YouTube. But for now, if you want them each week as they come out, you'll have to check out my Patreon, as that's where I'm uploading just the weekly recordings. So yeah, I compile them and it's free for everyone once the chapter has concluded. And I'm expecting Digimon Seekers to probably have 4 chapters, maybe even 5, with chapter 5 being the short one. But they did say it would run for at least a year, and it started in April, and it's November 29th. So, chapter 3 finishes in December, and we're getting a new chapter every 3 or 4 months. That kind of fits. So yeah, it is nice to have more Seekers stuff. I'm really enjoying Seekers. And that's why I started running it with the linker cable. So the buttons still have that tactic fit feel, which I haven't had on mine for a while. Let's check out the button backgrounds. Yeah, I still do enjoy the vinyl bracelet thingy, but the button issue is really, like, it's really bad. It's really annoying. The backgrounds are nice. They're kind of like these kind of cool cityscapes. Yeah, I do still love the BE, but wow, I really wish that Bandai did something about the button issue, because it's just really annoying. And yeah, if that top button hadn't completely lost its click either and become so, like, temperamental, I probably would have finished the, yeah, I have to press, like, pretty hard on the click to rip it. And, yes, it, sometimes the button one doesn't work, sometimes the top one gets stuck down and the button one doesn't work. So, yes, it is one of the ones I'm currently raising. Yeah, I want to finish this, but I really, it's a pain to finish it on this one because the buttons are broken. I wish that the
Hey YouTube, Joy Boy here.
Okay, so today I'm going to make a treat for my family. This is something my mom did when I was growing up, and I'm going to use biscuit dough from the store to make donuts. I might do a regular donut, I might do some twists, I don't know. I'm using the flaky layers, but the regular biscuit dough, the grahams, that's actually what we used growing up, but I had flaky layer grahams biscuit dough, so that's what I'm using. I'm going to open this. I'm working with this little knot here.
Hi, I use Febreze Fade Defy Plug.
And I use this.
Febreze has a microchip to control scent release, so it smells first day fresh for 50 days.
50 days?
And its refill reminder light means I'll never miss a day of freshness. Febreze Plug.
It's steakma season at Outback Steakhouse, where we deck the plates with new steak entrees. La 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 la, la 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 la. It all starts at $16.99. For a limited time, only.
Earth is a disgusting 30-year-old loser who picked the worst F-rank skills and became the most OP player in the game. In his real life, he had a job and worked hard to earn money, but instead of trying to find a girl to clap, he sat down at his desk to play a new virtual reality game. He thought he was an old loser, and he even called himself an old loser. But in the game, he felt young again. He could do all sorts of amazing things that he couldn't do in real life. He decided to name his character Earth, and he made Earth look very ordinary and boring. He didn't want to stand out because he wasn't the type who wanted to be the main character. He couldn't play the game all day because he had to work and be responsible. So, he could only play for a few hours every day. He worried that he might bother other players if he tried to play with them, so he mostly played by himself. When it came